Good morning, and welcome to the historic Basilica Cathedral of St. John the Baptist. We welcome all of you present and those joining us through live stream. We pray that you are in good health. We ask that all present respect the instructions given by our ushers and the guidelines in place to prevent the spread of COVID, including using hand sanitizers, maintaining a distance of 2 meters, and wearing face masks when entering, leaving, or moving within the church. The wearing of masks is optional while seated. At the time of communion, we will give you further instructions. At the end of Mass, we ask you to follow the usher's directions for leaving the church. Our presider today is Father Cecil Critch. Please stand.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Good morning again. We gather here with Heidi. Renewed our acquaintance from St. Pat's Hall School. It was wonderful to see you. And thank you for helping to plan today. And we gather with Jonathan, her son. We gather with the grandchildren, with sister Doreen and brothers John and Dermot, friends and extended family here of Elaine, and those watching live stream as well today. And I thank Nicholas Lim for doing that for me today, the live streaming. We gather today at this Mass, and of course Mass the whole Mass comes from the word Eucharist, really, which means thanksgiving. And we gather today now to thank God for the life of Elaine, and thank her for the great service she gave to the seniors at St. Patrick's Mercy Home for so many years, you know, her work as an LPN there. So God bless her for the hard work that she did. So we reflect this morning at the beginning of our funeral liturgy on her baptism. And in baptism, Elaine was given a share in the death and resurrection of Christ. She was clothed with the garment of salvation at baptism. So we surround her today with the church's prayer. And let us praise the Lord Jesus who has raised us to new life in baptism.
Our processional hymn is Amazing Grace, number 480 in the Catholic Book of Worship. Grace appear, the hour
and portion be, as long as life endures.
My brothers and sisters, we believe that all the ties of friendship and affection which knit us together throughout our lives do not unravel with death. Confident that God always remembers the good we have done and forgives our sins, let us pray, asking God to gather Elaine to himself. And we pray. O God, Almighty Father, our faith professes that your Son died and rose again. Mercifully grant that through this mystery, your servant Elaine, who has fallen asleep in Christ, may rejoice to rise again through him, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen. Please be seated now for our readings, and I call forward Doreen for the readings.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. The Spirit of the Lord God is upon me. Because the Lord has anointed me, he has sent me to bring good news to the oppressed, to bind up the brokenhearted, to proclaim liberty to the captives and release to the prisoners, to proclaim the year of the Lord's favor and the day of vengeance of our God, to comfort all who mourn, to provide for those who mourn to Zion, to give them a garland instead of ashes, the oil of gladness instead of mourning, the mantle of praise instead of faint spirit, the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The response to Psalm 23, the Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
Your staff.
There is nothing I shall want. You have prepared a banquet for me in the sight of my foes. My head you have anointed with oil. My cup is overflowing.
The Lord is my shepherd. There is nothing I shall want.
Surely goodness and kindness shall follow me all the days of my life. In the Lord's own house shall I dwell forever and ever.
The Lord is my shepherd. There is nothing I shall want.
We call back Doreen now for the second reading from Timothy.
A reading from the second letter of St. Paul to Timothy. Beloved, I am already being poured out as a liberation, and the time of my departure has come. I have fought the good fight. I have finished the race. I have lost the faith, from now on. There is reserved for me the crown of righteousness, which the Lord, the righteous judge, will give me on that day. And not only to me, but also to all those who have longed for his appearing. The Lord, the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Please stand.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
With you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Before the festival of the Passover, Jesus knew that the hour had come to depart from this world and go to the Father. Having loved his own who were in the world, he loved them to the end. And during supper, Jesus, knowing that the Father had given all things into his hands and that he had come from God and was going to God, got up from the table, took off his outer robe and tied a towel around himself. And then he poured water into a basin and began to wash the disciples' feet and to wipe them with the towel that was tied around him. He came to Simon Peter, who said to him, "Lord, are you going to wash my feet?" And Jesus answered, "You do not know now what I am doing, but later you will understand." And Peter said to him, "You will never wash my feet." And Jesus answered, "Unless I wash you, you have no share with me." And Simon Peter said to him, "Lord, not my feet, but also my hands and my head." And Jesus said to him, "One who has bathed does not need to wash, except for the feet, but is entirely clean. And you are clean, though not all of you." For he knew who was to betray him. After he had washed their feet, put on his robe, and returned to the table, Jesus said to them, "Do you know what I have done to you? You call me teacher and Lord, and you are right. That is what I am. So if I, your Lord and teacher, have washed your feet, you also ought to wash one another's feet. For I have set you an example that you should also do as I have done to you." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Please be seated. Today we gather to thank God for the life of Elaine, and we gather in faith and hope with her family to offer this Mass of Thanksgiving, really. We reflected on Elaine's baptism, when her parents Dermot and Magdalene brought her for baptism, and when the priest poured the water over her head in the name of the Trinity, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. She was made a child of God and a temple of the Holy Spirit, and she began her journey of faith, a journey that would lead her back to her Father in heaven, her true homeland. Elaine dedicated her life to her family, I'm told. As a single parent, she worked very hard all her life to support her family. She worked hard many years as LPN in nursing profession at St. Patrick's Mercy Home, caring for our vulnerable senior citizens. Elaine saw her work in nursing not just as a job. She saw it as a vocation to service, especially to the vulnerable elderly people. As an LPN, she was the physical presence of Christ to others by binding up their wounds, washing their feet, washing their bodies, and by sometimes mending their broken hearts when there were lonely elderly patients, some who received maybe no family visitors. Elaine sought to heal them in body, mind, and spirit. At every level of care and administration within the healthcare, nursing staff are called on to give that special care, that special gift of healing in their vocation. It's their vocation, not just a job. The root of that care is love. Love has bundled up inside of it all the aspects needed to be a good nurse, to be a good LPN in that profession, to be a good doctor too. Caring for the sick requires putting yourself second and your patients first. Elaine, in her nursing career, was one who simply did whatever she could for other people in her own humble way. She felt she was merely the servant of the Lord, doing her Christian duty as well. Whoever serves the sick for the sake of God's gracious promise has the great assurance that they shall in turn be cared for themselves. And we know Elaine was cared for when she developed dementia at a young age and just after retirement. The family thanks Angela, especially her niece, and the people at Kenny's Pond for that special care for her during her time there, her illness time. The Gospel from St. John today speaks of the meaning of service of other people. Jesus shows by example to the apostles that love and service of others means that we must wash the feet of others. In the Middle East, you know, that job always fell to the servant of the house. When a traveler visited, their feet, having walked a distance in the sand, needed to be washed before they entered the house. It was the gesture and love of welcoming a guest. So Jesus washed the feet of the apostles at the Last Supper to show them that just as they received the body of Jesus at the table of the Eucharist, at the table of the Last Supper, they must also be the body of Jesus for one another, to serve them in love. Today I know that you, Elaine's family and friends, are grateful to God for the special gift that God gave you in the person of Elaine as she laid down her life daily for her families and others with great love. Elaine, of course, shared with me that Elaine looked after even her own mom in her illness and loved her grandchildren dearly and loved going on trips to Eastport with them. So she had a full life with her grandchildren when she got the chance to do it, because she was always working, I was told. So today, you know, we are reminded that Christ suffered and died for our sins and rose again and promises his faithful ones will also rise to new life with him. His heavenly kingdom awaits us where there will be no more pain or suffering, no more death. Our joy in heaven will consist in being continually in God's loving presence. In our life's journey, crosses do come our way. Our sufferings we encounter as Christians, but we join them with the sufferings of Jesus for the salvation of the world. Earthly pain accepted in union with Christ leads to eternal life. For Jesus promised to help us bear our crosses with us through the love, especially of our family and friends and caregivers. Elaine was a woman of deep faith. She believed that the greatest healer, the divine physician, was Christ, and Elaine's faith and her belief in these heavenly realities helped her greatly in her life's journey. How else could she have been so courageous and patient and graceful during her time of suffering herself? And we asked the question at all these funerals that we have, you know, at the end of our life, how will we be judged? Jesus taught us the answer, and so did Elaine. We'll be judged. We'll be not judged by our money or possessions or titles that we have, but how we have loved others in practical everyday ways, how we have washed one another's feet, how we have been the body of Christ for other people. That is the true and basic meaning of our Christian religion, you know. So we pray today that Jesus will take Elaine to the rest and peace of his kingdom. Elaine was a good and faithful servant of God. We commend her to the mercy of God. You have fought the good fight, Elaine. You have won the race. You have kept the faith. Now receive the crown of righteousness prepared for you. May the smiles of the martyrs and the songs of the angels greet you on your heavenly journey. The beautiful prayer of St. Ignatius of Loyola, the patron or the founder of the Jesuits, could be a prayer of everyone, I think, in the medical profession, nurses and LPNs and doctors as well. I'll just read that beautiful little prayer to end off my homily. It says, Lord, teach me to be generous. Teach me to serve you as you deserve, and to give and not count the cost, to fight and not heed the wounds, to toil and not to seek for rest, to labor and not to ask for reward, save that of knowing that I do your will. Amen. We are going to pray the intercessions now. So whoever the intercessor is, to come forward to the microphone there, the intercessions. I think Sky is coming forward. Please stand now and as we pray together. Brothers and sisters, Jesus Christ is risen from the dead and sits at the right hand of the Father, where he intercedes for his church. Confident that God hears the voice of those who trust in the Lord Jesus, we join our prayers to his.
The response to the intercessions is, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
In baptism, Elaine received the light of Christ. Scatter the darkness now and lead her over the waters of death. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Our sister Elaine was nourished at the table of the Savior. Welcome her into the halls of the heavenly banquet. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have Family and friends of Elaine seek comfort and consolation, heal their pain and dispel the darkness and doubt that comes from grief. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We are assembled in faith and confidence to pray for our sister Elaine. Strengthen our hope so that we may live in the expectation of our son's coming. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Lord Jesus Christ, giver of peace and healer of soul, hear our prayers and the voices of your people whose lives were purchased by the blood of the Lamb. Forgive the sins of all who sleep in Christ and grant them a place in the kingdom through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. Please be seated now for the second part of our Eucharist, which is the Liturgy of the Eucharist, our offertory and communion. Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Please stand. Let us pray. Look favorably on our offerings, O Lord, so that your departed servant Elaine may be taken up into glory with your Son, in whose great mystery of love we are all united. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord, in him the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended, and when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so with all the angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Lord God of hosts. Heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them, like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed, he took bread and gave it to his disciples. He broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
And therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, spread her out to the whole world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Peter our Bishop, the clergy, and all your people. Remember your servant Elaine, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that she who was united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in the resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. And we remember today all the members of Elaine's family who have gone before her in faith. Welcome all of them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostle St. John the Baptist, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs with them to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Pray together the prayer that of all Christians around the world, the prayer that Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. The kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ has said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever." Peace of the Lord be with you always. And we share the peace of Christ in some way to one another. Peace be with you all.
Lamb of God.
Lord, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world.
And behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
A prayer for those who are unable to receive Holy Communion at this time. My Jesus, I believe you are present in the most blessed sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you, for you are already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. To ensure that the reception of Holy Communion takes place in a safe and respectful manner, we ask that you please follow these instructions. Instead of individually replying Amen upon receiving the host, there will be one general attestation of Amen before distribution begins. Please remain standing in your pew until invited forward by an usher. Ensure your face mask is correctly worn before coming forward, and maintain a 2-meter social distance in the communion line. As you approach the front of the line, sanitize your hands before receiving communion. Bow towards the host. In silence, receive the host in your hands. Step aside to consume the host. Return to your pew as directed by ushers. Those unable to receive Holy Communion in the hand may come forward to receive a blessing.
Yes, and anyone who is, hasn't received Holy Communion, first Holy Communion can come forward for a blessing if they'd like. The body of Christ.
Amen.
Hey! and see, taste and see the goodness of the Lord. Oh, taste and see.
Let us pray. Please stand. Lord God, whose Son left us in the sacrament of his body food for the journey, mercifully grant that strengthened by it, our sister Elaine may come to the eternal table of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our sister Elaine. May our last farewell express our affection for her. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet her again with the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself. In baptism, Elaine shared in the death and resurrection of Christ. We use this holy water now. May she be welcomed into the glory of eternal life. The incense that we use, of course, is from the plants of the Middle East, and the incense is always a sign of Jewish burial rites of respect for the body of the person, respect for the remains of the person, and it was a sign of like in preparing the body and preparing the person for entry into the next world, into eternal life. So today we use this incense again as a sign of respect for our sister Elaine, and let this incense rise to God, who has called her to share in his glory.
May songs of the angels welcome you and guide you along your way. May the smiles of the greet your own as darkness turns into day. Every fear will be undone, and death will be no more. As songs of the angels bring you home before
dear hands, Father of mercies, we commend our sister Elaine in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, she will rise with him. We give you thanks for the blessings which you bestowed upon Elaine in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn toward us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant Elaine and help us to remain to comfort one another with the assurances of faith until we all meet in Christ and are with you and with our sister, Elaine, forever.
Amen.
On behalf of the family, I'd like to thank all of you for your presence here today. I'd like to especially thank Heidi for helping with the planning today. Certainly, our Sky and Doreen, our readers, we'd like to thank Patty and Barbara here for the music, for the Mass, to calls for their professional service, Brother Rick and our ushers here for helping the usual Basilica people who help us in our everyday Masses here at the Basilica. To thank all of you for your presence here today. May Almighty God bless all of us, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended. Let us go now in peace.
Our recessional hymn is How Great Thou Art, number 554 in the CBW, and it will be led by Tina Durdle, Elaine's niece, Tina.
Hi.